steals the egg and it's not really and it turns out to be like rubber. Times of joy, celebrate with them, nourishing their love for one another.
We will.
Good answer. Will James Franklin come up for the first reading?
The Gift from the Sea, Anne Moreau Lindbergh. When you love someone, you do not love them all the time, in exactly the same way from moment to moment. It is an impossibility. It is even a lie to pretend to. And yet, this is exactly what most of us demand. We have so little faith in the ebb and flow of life, of love, of relationships. We leap at the flow of the tide and resist in terror its ebb. We are afraid it will never return. Security in a relationship lies neither in looking back to what was in nostalgia, nor forward to what it might be in dread or anticipation, but living in the present relationship and accepting it as it is now. Relationships must be like islands. One must accept them for what they are, here and now, within their limits, islands surrounded and interrupted by the sea, and continually visited and abandoned by the tides.
Instructions for Life in the New Millennium by His Holiness the 4th Dalai Lama. Take into account that great love and great achievements involve great risk, and that a loving atmosphere in your home is the foundation for your life. Be gentle for the earth, be gentle with one another. When disagreements come, remember always to protect the spirit of your union. When you realize you've made a mistake, take immediate steps to correct it. Remember, the best relationship in one is one in which your love for each other exceeds your need for each other. So love yourselves, love one another, love all in your life together, and all else will follow.
You're my best friend. And from the day I saw you walking down the dock in your board shorts, I knew that you were the one. This year, like every year so far, has tempered our love. We decided to do all of the things, and it's made us stronger. This reminds me of a quote I heard yesterday. Faith rise highest against the wind. I love you because you put friends and family first.
Hey, what's your name?
I will support you and do the same. I love you because we make memories like this. I will always be by your side to make more. Regardless of your wins. I love you because in the face of challenges, you rise highest. I will always be there for you in the face of adversity.
Packy Lochran, you had me at Ahoy. You are my best friend, you know me better than anyone, and you still want to marry me. Your love pushes me to be the best me I can possibly be. I love your spontaneity. Your up for anything, roll with the punches attitude is so different from my own, but you balance me out. I'm so grateful you've taught me how to sit back and enjoy the ride sometimes. I will live each day of our life together in the moment with you. I will be in the present with the knowledge that change is the only constant. I promise to support your many diverse interests and hobbies, both those that we share together and those hobbies that are all your own. These things make you happy, and your happiness is contagious. I will always be true to you and devoted to the beautiful life that we are building together. I will carry snacks with me at all times so that I can avoid getting hangry at you. I will stand by your side to celebrate the most joyful moments of our life and support you through the biggest challenges we will face. Because from here on out, we're in it together. I love you.
Love.
our family and from the Lochran family. On behalf of both families, we know a lot of you traveled a long way to get here, some people from Florida, and we thank you for that. For being a part of today's event with Sara and Packy. And it's a happy day. We thank you for being here with us to share this happy day and make memories for them which will last a long, long time. And I'd like to thank some other people who aren't here today, but they're here in spirit. And we thank those people who aren't here but are with us in spirit and watching over. Not the drones, but so I'd like you to eat, drink, be merry, help them create good memories for today, and I'm sure they will. Thank you again for being here. Thank you.
Thank you.
On the road again, just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again, going places that I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way, and our way is on the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. Love is making music with my friend, and I can't wait to get on the road again.
Everyone made long trips down here. Those of you that spent week-long vacations, I hope you enjoyed every minute of it. I know I did. I would not be here right now. I never would have come to the Outer Banks right now without that one right there. So a big thank you to them for bringing us all together. For those of you that don't know, my name is Mark. I have known Sara since the first grade. She's very fond of calling me her oldest and dearest, which I have to point out, she is older than I am. So I'll take the name, but I do like to remind her of that. It is only a few months. But so through those years, we have a lot of really happy memories from, you know, rolling chair races down the hallways of elementary school when we were supposed to be editing the school newspaper. Endless summer barbecues and 4th of July parties at the King household holds really special places in my heart. And, you know, our cherished fashion victim of the day.
Fashion victim of the
which
day.
Which did continue even when I was studying abroad. Before the time of iPhones and Snapchat, we actually had to talk on the phone and say what hideous thing someone was wearing that day. We've grown a little bit since then, I will say. We're a little kinder inside. And I think for her, a lot of that has to do with the gentleman standing next to her. So one of the things that I have realized out of all of the great couples I know in my life is that when they're together, they make each other better. And whenever these two are around, you feel the joy, you feel the love, you feel the laughter, and you just feel the life that they both exude and are enjoying together, and that we are all looking forward to seeing them build as time goes forward. So it's really been a privilege for me to be here to watch her get ready, to watch the planning, and to watch her turn from, you know, the slightly mousy-haired, long-haired little girl into the beautiful woman that she is now. I couldn't be happier that you two found each other. I knew the moment you passed the sniff test with the cats that you were the one that I'm watching right now, keeping all three eyes on you as we speak. So I just want to close and say, you know, I wish you guys the best, brightest future possible. I'm going to be following and rooting for you from behind the entire way, and so is absolutely everyone here right now. So if you'll all join me in raising a glass.
Yep.
So thank you, Mark. And again, I just want to echo Mark's comments about thanking everybody else for being here. We know that everybody made a long trip, and it's been an awesome time because of everybody here and all the planning that's gone into this. So when I was first deciding which high school to go to, I used to tell people that I didn't want to go to St. Joe's Prep, which is where Packy went, because I didn't want to end up like him. It was mainly to piss him off, because every time I said that to you, you were just like, fuck you, Tom. This is ridiculous. But it was also like a little bit of insecurity, because Packy's an awesome guy, some big shoes to fill, obviously. But thankfully, I made the right decision. I went to the same high school as Packy, and I've made the right decision plenty times since by following Packy to other places, like in our career and other areas. And every time that I've followed him to those places, it's kind of amazing because I'll always have a group of like 10 or 20 people that come up to me within the first week of me starting at these places. And they always immediately want to get to know me and talk to me because I'm Packy's brother. And it's like, you immediately, think about being a freshman in high school, first day of high school, and I have all these people coming up to me just wanting to talk to me because I'm Packy's brother. And obviously, I'm gonna take that and run with it. It worked out perfectly for me. So I'd somehow gained this false sense of confidence that I've kept until today. But yeah, and I mean, so having Sara come into Packy's life, and I'll tell a little story about the first day that I met Sara. Packy was having a we met like briefly at Jack's place, but we don't need them anyway. There was a party that Packy was having in Fairmount at the apartment that he lived at with Matt Kelly for Bastille Day. And in typical Packy party fashion, nobody was showing up. So I came over early, started hanging out with you, and I noticed that you were like pacing, terrified and nervous. You were so nervous that nobody was going to show up, and then you also mentioned that this girl was coming over. I've never seen you more nervous in my life, and then the moment, so other people eventually came by, but then Sarah showed up like an hour in, and I could immediately tell why you were nervous. And it was because she's way out of your league. it's astonishing, but anyway. Then Sarah immediately was engaging with everybody in the room, a group of people. Again, somebody said last night that being a friend of Packy is like being in the biggest inside joke of your life. Like, that Sarah immediately was welcome there. And she's done it like all of our family events and family parties. Sarah walks in, and if you've ever been to like a family event, it's essentially me, Packy, and my mom talking over each other in increasing volume throughout the entire night. And Sarah somehow is able to layer herself into that, and it works out. So that was me realizing that Sarah was a great girl. But really, the moment that I realized that Packy and Sarah were going to spend the rest of their life together, it was It was a really sort of sad day. It was our father had just passed away, and it was actually at his funeral, at his burial. And we were burying our dad, and as like everything was coming to a close, I noticed that Packy and Sara were off to the corner, just hugging. And I saw that, and it was like I could just see that it was a moment of support that would continue. And you had so Sara was such a great rock for you during that time. And it sort of made me realize that relationships are about the good times, like a Bastille Day party, we're all having fun. But they're really more about how you get through those tough times. And everybody, you've had some tough times. But you guys have been fantastic and just awesome to be around and see grow together. So thank you so much for letting me toast you guys. And just, I want to close by just saying thank you for letting me talk about how awesome you guys are together. So let's raise a glass. Cheers. Cheers. Pack and Sara.
You guys are awesome. Serve our food, dude. Yeah.
Oh, I hold your picture to my fresh. Love you, dear, and I ain't know I knew anything in the world. Just moving in my baby's eye. Just moving in my baby's eye. I'm moving in my baby's eye. I'm moving in my baby's eye. Love you, baby. Love you, baby.
Long time. time ago, said the fine old woman. Long time ago, this proud old woman did say there was war and death, plundering and pillage, my children starve, my mountain valley and sea, and their wailing cries, they shook the very heavens, my four green fields ran red with their blood, said she. This proud old woman did say, I have four green fields, one of them's in bondage, in strangers' hands, that try to take it from me, but my sons have sons, as brave as were their fathers, my fourth green field will bloom once again, said she.
Presumably sailing. Ready?
Got this salad.